When people talk with each other, it is known that each of these three can be different from the others. What the speaker meant, what I said, and what the other understood. In the light of this insight, the question of this talk is how conversational assistants should answer a complex question for which more than one answer exists. Our challenge is that listing the answers is not good enough. Take this presentation as an example. When we prepared the presentation, we thought about how to best prepare you, our audience, for what we want to get across. I could have simply listed the research questions we propose in the paper. Maybe you would then pay attention to and remember the first one. Or maybe one of our research questions reminds you of some other research and you later misremember that this is what our paper is about. No. The difference between what we meant and what you understand can be quite large if such a complex topic is presented by just a simple list. Why should it be different when you talk with an intelligent assistant about a complex topic? Argumentation is how we as humans deal with complex topics, topics that have no clear answer. Now, when you ask an artificial intelligence on this topic, you usually get lots of interesting or funny answers. But usually no helpful one. Now, there's a large appeal to a system that assists you in exploring a complex topic. In your own way of talking, at your own pace, never tired of why. But lists, as we know them from search engines, provide a strict ordering that is even emphasized in voice. And if we are not fully concentrated on the task, our heuristic minds will jump to conclusions about what is important and what is not. The first, the most familiar. Moreover, a list might suggest you have heard all that you need, and in argumentation, that is rarely the case. Let me illustrate this with the discussion topology of should there be a universal basic income on the discussion webpage Kiado. This blue disk is the question. These 9 segments are pros and cons collected from the community. If you would ask an intelligent assistant, it could present you a list of these 9. But there's more to this. Each of the 9 has pros and cons of its own that strengthen and weaken it. Evidence, rebuttals. How to make it clear that these are available? In total, this one community collected 2,800 claims for that single topic. Of course, not all are important to hear for everyone, but how else to show the complexity of the topic than by such a structure? And we have not even talked about quality ratings and comments yet. So, for a complex topic, this whole wealth of information is kind of what we, as intelligent assistants, mean to give as an answer. Of course, we can't actually say all of this, we have to select. And then we hope that the user actually understands what we meant from what we said. Let me repeat. The user asks a question on a complex topic. We assume the assistant has a wealth of information that it means to say, but the assistant has to select what to say. Very little for a voice interface. This selection introduces a bias. And then the user interprets what the assistant said, using both rational thinking and heuristics. The latter, heuristics, are often the dominant part and are affected by cognitive biases. How to deal with the situation? Well, we don't know. But we argue that to get an answer, we should ask the following questions. First, to create a basis for conversations on complex topics, how to get both the user and the assistant to understand how the other one works. Then, for the specific topic at hand, how can the assistant explain to the user how and why it selected what it said or will say? And how to give the user control over the selection? And then, to avoid misinterpretation, how can the assistant either silently compensate for the user's bias or directly help the user identify the bias for mitigation? Our challenge is that just listing the answers is not good enough for making sure the user understands what the assistant actually meant.